Paul is a research scientist. He likes to work on his research, but given this opportunity to provide a service to the public that pulled him away from his work, that pulled him out of his environment, he readily stepped up. This was, you know, not something that's in his job description, but it was a way for him to make a tangible contribution, and he did that readily, and as it turned out, he made a significant difference. So Paul's activities in the oil spill reflect well on him personally, as well as the National Research Program, and as well on public servants in general.
I started with the USGS in 1977 after I finished my undergraduate degree. In fact, I was hired here in Reston, Virginia by John Bredehoff, who was then the chief of research. And I worked with him on the relationship between fluid pressure and earthquakes. And then after a year, I went to graduate school and I stayed part-time. The survey has been great to me in terms of supporting my education and my research while I was at grad school. And then when I finished, I moved out to Menlo Park in 1983, and I've been there ever since.
We're very proud of Paul Hsieh. He's a long-term member of the National Research Program. He's worked on groundwater flow modeling for a number of years, trying to solve difficult groundwater flow model or groundwater flow problems. He's helped in the development of models, and he was asked by Secretary Chu to serve on his science team. And so, you know, even though that took him away from his primary love, his research, he served on that team. And then he was given an opportunity, fairly unexpected, to solve a difficult problem. He did it in a creative way. He did it quickly. He and his work actually had a great impact in terms of the decisions about what was going to happen in the Gulf. So we're proud of him as a research scientist. We're happy for him. We're glad. It reflects well on the National Research Program and in public service in general.
The Deepwater Horizon explosion happened on April 20th. At that time, I was just like anybody else watching the news and hoping that they would stop the oil flow. And I wasn't called in to work with the science team until in the later part of June, when a number of attempts to stop the oil flow failed. And eventually, plan was to put a cap on the well. So a team of USGS scientists went to Houston to work with Director Marsha McNutt on, first of all, analyzing whether it's appropriate to put the cap on, and then after the cap was put on, to evaluate whether it was working or not. One big worry about putting the cap on was that the oil well itself may have been damaged. And if the oil well was damaged, then putting the cap on could create a leak underground somewhere else that eventually could erode a pathway to the ocean, to the seafloor. And then that would be a different avenue for oil to come out, and in fact, it would create an uncontrollable spill. So when the oil cap was put on, the pressure in the cap was right at an intermediate level, making it very difficult to decide on whether the cap was working, whether the oil was contained, or whether there was a leak in the well. And I was asked to do the modeling analysis to help with that decision. The decision had to be made within 24 hours of putting the cap on, so I had very little time to do this analysis. I basically stayed up all night, did the analysis, and presented it to the government team in the morning. And based on that analysis, the government team decided to keep the cap on, and the cap stayed on, and there was no oil released after that. At the time that the cap was put on, the pressure measurements from the well was sent to the BP office in Houston. I had actually returned home to Menlo Park, and so I didn't have access to that pressure data, which were critical for my analysis. So my colleague, Steve Hickman, who was in Houston at the BP building, took a picture of the computer display showing the chart of how the pressure was rising with time and sent that picture to me. And then based on that picture, I was able to then get the data to do my analysis.
Paul's work was very creative. He used the ModFlow groundwater flow model that has been developed over the last 20 years, 25 years, by the National Research Program and by others in USGS. And Paul's worked on that model, and it's been used to solve water problems around the world. In fact, it's the most widely used groundwater flow model in the world. So Paul was very creative in applying this model to the oil reservoir beneath the Gulf. And he was able to do that partly because the oil kind of had properties that were similar to water in this particular case. The oil wasn't too hot and it wasn't pressurized to the point that it was boiling. So that allowed him to be creative and solve that problem.
Working on the Deepwater Horizon oil spill was a career highlight for me. It's kind of ironic that I spent my career working in water, but the knowledge and the skills that are appropriate to water can be transferred to analyzing an oil flow situation.
So we're proud of him, just personally for him. He's labored as a government scientist in sort of obscurity, and he has an opportunity here with this to shine, and he makes us all proud. And
that's an inherent aspect of working with earth science, because you have limited amounts of measurements and you just can't know everything. The advice I would share with an up-and-coming young scientist is to number of things. First would be to really know the fundamentals of the subject that you are doing work on. Keep sharpening your skills so that you can apply them without having to constantly look up procedures and so on. Look for different opportunities to apply your skills to different situations, and work with as many of the experts within the USGS. There are so many people with a diversity of expertise within the USGS that there are just so many opportunities to work with people and learn from them.
So Paul is the first Department of Interior scientist to receive this award. He's the first earth scientist to receive the award. A few other scientists have received awards. They've been kind of human health scientists. So, as an earth science agency, as a hydrologic research program or the water research program in the USGS, this reflects well on our long-term commitment to research and our capability to solve difficult problems in a short amount of time.
My entire career with the USGS has been wonderful. I have absolutely no regrets about missing any other opportunities of working any place else. I feel a great amount of affection for the USGS. It is my professional family. One of the things that I remember very vividly from when I was first hired was sitting in meetings in which high-level administrators and leaders talk about the USGS as if we were a family, and that is something that I always associate with when I think of the USGS.